guys, my name is Willem and welcome to LRDX Cars. Like you can see, today I am at AE Cars here in Isegem in Belgium to check out some very cool cars. Isegem is a known Porsche dealer, but also a supercar dealer. So like you can see, they have a lot of very special sports cars and a lot of Porsches here on the outside. I think they have the longest line of Porsche 997 Carreras that I have ever seen. Also a very cool 911R here on the outside, one of 500. The car that you hear in the background is a 991.2 GT3 with a touring pack. Some new 992s, a nice Ferrari 458 like you can see. It's a 430 Scuderia, an Audi R8, Lamborghini. Gonna show them all today to you guys. If video gets too long, I will probably put it in two parts. But yeah, enjoy watching with me, guys. Then, if we're starting off here on the outside, we can see a lot of Porsches. They are mostly known for selling their second-hand Porsches. But like you can see, they also have other sports cars here, like the Audi R8 or the 458, all different brands. But yeah, I want to first start off with this very special car. It's a Porsche 911R. It's based on the 991.1, so the previous generation, and then the first, not the facelift of the previous generations of 911s. The special thing about this car is that it was only available in a manual gearbox. You can see, I'm gonna take a look at some of the options. It's for sale here at €320,000. The car has a 4-liter flat six, of course, with 500 horsepower. And then if you take a quick look on the inside, you can see the very cool fabric on the seats and of course the manual gearbox, a lot of carbon fiber to finish it off. I'm gonna quickly open up the car so you guys also can have a quick look. The door handles, just a latch or a leash, just save weight. Then a nice 911R door sill and carbon fiber, and then the cool 918 bucket seats, carbon fiber, and then the very nice old fabric, very known at Porsche. I think it looks very good. They have a subtle old school detail. Then, like you can see, the car goes to 8,500 RPMs. And then the most noticeable feature, of course, is the manual gearbox, finished in a nice carbon fiber. Very cool. And I'll show you the badge on this side. This is car number 280 of the 991 that were made. I was wrong. It was 991, not 500 cars. And you can see the spoiler in its up mode for now. You can see the 991.1 generation of rear lights. Nice emblem, 911R. Then of course the center exhausts. Why they actually built the 911R is because in the generation of the 991.1 GT3, you could only opt for a PDK box. Not all of Porsche purists were complaining about it, that they wanted the manual, and that's why they sort of brought out this special model for the purists that still want the manual. This car also has the ceramics, as you can see. Most of the time, the 911Rs have a double stripe over the bonnet and over the roof of the car and the spoiler, but this car is just full white. Then in the second generation of the 991, this is the 991.2, they thought, yeah, we should bring back the manual in the more standard GT3 cars that everyone can order. So they chose to go with a touring package. Like you can see, this car has a touring package. It's mostly the delete of the rear wing, but also, like you can see, the manual gearbox, the 6-speed manual this car uses. So also quite cool, also a nice look. I prefer the look of the 911-2 of rear lights. I think the rear lights on that car look a bit better than in the first generation of the 991. And then of course the delete of the spoiler, then the manual gearbox. Of course, I think after the second or the third year of production of the 901.2 GT3s, you could also opt for a manual car with a spoiler. But I think in the beginning, you only could choose it on the touring package, the manual gearbox. I think it's also a very good look. Not too much in your face, like when you have the spoiler. And like you can see, on the 911R, there will also be a small spoiler lip opening up. This car has 500 horsepower, like the same as the 911R. This car is finished in a GT Silver Metallic. All the nice air intakes. And this is probably my favorite generation of GT3, and this car is for sale at 170,000 euros. And that is about 26,000 kilometers, so not that much driven, and still a very good price, I think. Then if you go further, you can see a Ferrari 458, one of my all-time favorite Ferraris, the last naturally aspirated V8. This one in a nice Rosso Corsa with a tan interior and the gold wheels. This is the 4.5 liter, 570 horsepower V8. And then the 458 is mostly known with the 3 exhausts, like on the F40 in the middle, where the great sound comes from. Very good looking car, I think, still. With an aggressive diffuser, the gold painted wheels. I don't think they are standard gold. And then a nice tan interior, like you can see. Then we have two 996 Porsches here. This one even is a Turbo S 996. And yeah, in the last years, the 996 really was appreciated again. In the past, nobody really liked the 996 Porsches because they had the weird look of the headlights. Or the egg shape of the headlights. But the last years, this even is a Targa, the cars really get appreciated again, like all the Porsche 911s, of course. And I also think that cars still look good. They're all for sale here. Then we have, like I said, probably the longest lineup of 997 Porsches. I think in all different variations, the cabrio models, the turbo models, even the 4S or the Turbo S models. And this is a 992 Porsche and a very beautiful adventure in green metallic color, which looks very good, I think. Green on a Porsche is always good. And also the upgraded RS design wheels, which also have a very good look. This car is also running at the moment, 4S. Then next with the last generation of 911.2, but this is the Targa car. And like you can see, the difference from the 991.2 to the 992 is, I think, immense. Not only the rear lights have changed a lot, but the car has gone a bit wider. The arches of the wheels, of the back wheels, are made wider. And yeah, the car just gets a more modern look, I think. The 991.2 was a bit outdated. Then all different sorts, Targas, cabrios. I'm gonna just walk past them because there are too much to review all. Targa 4S, Carrera 4S. Even with a nice spoiler on and the dual exhaust, which looks very good. I think the 997 is also a very good looking car. And the Turbo S, it's also a bit bigger. Very standard turbo. Maybe we're gonna check some differences, of course. The ceramics on the Turbo S, of course, are standard. Also a manual car, it's still a manual Turbo S. denk ik, de 997 was about the last turbo model they offered with a manual. So I think it also will be a future classic. Quickly take a look, this car is priced at 80,000 euros, which is not that bad. Another 997 turbo. Then they are moving some cars here. Another turbo, previous generation of Boxster, the 981 I think was his name. And then they have very bright colors here of the 992. All cars are for sale that you can see, so if you are interested, go to their website aecars.com or come to their showroom in Isingham. I think this Porsche is in a sort of lizard green. Nice sound on the background, which is looks quite good. And then of course the racing yellow, the Miami blue. This car is a cabrio model. Quickly take a look on the interior, the updated interior of course. Very beautiful looking color, the nice lizard green. And also one of my favorite colors at the moment I think is this blue. Well, it's not night blue metallic, it's the name. Name is, yeah, forgot it for now I think. There is also a nice yellow rev counter. And then the racing yellow Porsche 992. That's the glass roof, which is a very good looking car in the sun. And it's the summer or the spring, it's almost starting. So if you are interested in a car, it's now the time to look around that you can drive it when the weather is good and I can see the sun is shining. This car also has the ceramic brakes, which looks quite good to match with the yellow exterior. This car is 155, only 11,000 kilometers. Nice roof, like I said. Then the last generation of Targa 4 GDS in a very cool Miami blue. They don't make that color anymore, and I think that's a very good looking color. Really gives me summer feelings. I just always get happy when I see a car in that color. And then of course the Targa model and the GTS of course, to make it more sporty with the more turbo style wheels, center locks, and of course the suspension, the special Porsche suspension system to make the car a bit sportier in the corners. And of course the upgraded engine, that's 450 horsepower. Then I'm not gonna mention all the Porsches, but like you can see, 991 generations also, cabrios, hardtops, Panameras, all kind of Porsches they have here. But what I'm gonna talk about is, because of course we are the supercar channel, are these beautiful Ferraris that are parked on the outside. This very beautiful Ferrari 458. Like we saw a Rosso Corsa one, this one is more the Grigio Silverstone one, also with the gold wheels, gold painted wheels, which give more of a classy look. Also with the more black leather interior and the yellow stitch in it, which matches with the brake calipers. Then this car has sort of an extra upgrade, like you can see. An extra spoiler or a small extra lip this car has, which gave a more sporty look to it. And then next to it, a very, very good looking car, the Ferrari F12 with the V12, the 6.3 liter V12 from Ferrari. I think this car is a was the predecessor of the new A12, but what I was going to say is that I think this car has a even a better look than the new A12 Ferrari, because of course this was designed by Pininfarina still, and now it's more of the computer design I think they use at Ferrari, which miss some of the flair Ferrari had. Like you can see here, the Pininfarina logo. Of course go to AE Cars if you're interested in the nice, more upgraded wheels, not the standard wheels of the F12 with the nice Rosso brake calipers from Brembo. Of course, ceramic brakes, because this car has a V12, like I told, with 740 horsepower on the rear wheels. So this car is quite nuts, I think, quite fast. I think the top speed will run about 340 kilometers an hour, which is about 210 miles an hour, I think, which is immense for a car that you can actually drive on the road. And yeah, like I said, the look of this car, I think, is even better than the last car. Sorry, it's a bit dirty, but you can see the big air intakes in the front. Even these air intakes open up to cool the brakes. And then the very good looking headlights, an extra air outlet to let all the hot air out of the engine bay. And if you're standing here, you can see these two air veins. The air can float actually under here, come out here to create more downforce on the front nose. And quick look on the interior. Nice carbon fiber steering wheel and the carbon fiber panels. Really a must option if you guys ever buy a Ferrari. Please choose those two carbon fiber options. Only if that are the only carbon fiber options you would pick. I think the steering wheel and the pedals is really something that, yeah, most of the people really like. Then the sort of cool design in the rear of the car, or the back. Just, yeah, it's more elegant, it has style, like you can see this car. Very big rear tires. And then the two exhausts on each side, where you can hear the beautiful V12 sound through. Then this F1 inspired fog light, which is very cool. And of course, some active air, some diffuser to let the air float underneath the car. Some extra air outlets, I think also for the rearwheel arches to let the hot air out. And then a little trunk, you can open up the rear window and you have a little trunk. Then, if you take a further look, we're going crazy with the supercars. You can see this very, very brutal Lamborghini Huracan. I think it's the LP610-4 Huracan. So the four-wheel drive V10 Huracan. And like you can see, this car has a body kit put on it, which give them very, very aggressive look to it. Now you can see the front lip is extended, I think by about 10 centimeters. That the car is extended. And also these extra air veins on the side of the car to let the air flow next to the car. Very cool. The fins on it. It will probably also help to give more downforce on the front nose. And these very cool mesh grill air intakes, that the cool air can flow to the radiators. And of course, because it's a mid-mounted engine, you also, or the trunk space is in the front, so it's a frunk. You have the luggage space in the front. Then take a look at the wheels, very cool, more bronze looking style of wheels, which looks very good, I think, to complement with the full black, to not let everything be black. And then the yellow brake calipers that you can see. I think this car also has the ceramic brakes. And like you see on the side, an extra side skirt to even give a more sporty look on the side. You can see this side, this panel is actually not standard. And the LP610-4 stands for Lamborghini, 610 horsepower and four-wheel drive. Then you open up the doors like this. A quick look on the interior, we can see the Louis Vuitton seat belts. It's even the yellow stitch in it. Very cool. Then this car is a spider, of course. The soft top can fold in the rear on top of the engine. It said that you can't see the engine in the spider, but you can't have everything. Then if you take a look on the rear, see the rear is also made a bit more aggressive. You can see this extra underlip is put it extra on the car. It's not a standard rear. And I also think this part is not standard. Nice sound of that Q5. I think it was a R model of RS. And you can see also an extra spoiler put on top with these flicks on the side. It gives a way more aggressive look. Like you guys can see, the Huracan doesn't come standard with a spoiler, so it's always nice to have a spoiler if you're that kind of guy that likes the more aggressive look. Then you see some pieces of the engine from the V10 engine underneath, and then we can hear probably the V10 sound through the double exhaust on each side. This will give probably a very, very good sound. I also think they don't look as standard exhaust, like the rest of the car isn't standard, so probably the exhaust won't also be. And we're gonna take a look further. You can see the lineup continues of Porsches, even a nice BMW M3, a Mini Junk Cooperworks, new Audi TT cars, the A6, nice Macan, a new Macan also, and then an Audi A7, also the new A7, which looks quite good, Porsche Cayman, a Boxster, some Panameras, and like you can see, they even clean the cars here, very nice. They also have a big workshop here on the inside, so if your car needs service, they will also do it for you. Yeah, and then I think I'm gonna end the first part of this video here, and then in the second part we're gonna take a look at all the cars on the inside. Like you can see, they have also very cool cars on the inside, and I want to say a big thank you for now. Thanks for watching, guys, and please subscribe to see the second part of this video. Bye guys, see you in the next video.